Alright, I'm back with another Destiny 2 video, and I didn't know if I was going to do the TWAB today or not, but I heard this one has a lot of crafting stuff in it, so I figured I probably should. Before we dive in, please join us in sending Mara Juno, English voice of Ikora Ray, well wishes and hopes for speedy recovery. Yeah, I saw this on Twitter, and definitely hopes that she is able to recover quickly. Alright. This week at Bungie, we're humming along to a Deepstone lullaby. Boo, did I scare you? Doubtful, as I tried this trick in a TWAB before. Happy Festival of the Lost Guardians. As tradition, we'll start with a quick recap of what's going on in the wild. Headless ones are roaming lost sectors on the hunt for ghosts, but if you've already taken up the task of cleaning house, between a volt shot roll on the legendary Macabre sniper rifle or some spicy perks on previous festival weapons, kill clip, Braytech, werewolf, anyone? There's some fun loot to earn, too. We've already seen a few gilded ghost raiders in town. I'm like, I swear to God, like 200 candy away from gilded ghost rider. 30,000 candy is an unpleasant amount of candy. We can only hope that they're sharing some of the candy they've been eating. We've also been running some fun fashion and art contests for players. Toward the end of this article, you'll see a few awesome creations from our players. But first, let's take a look at some of the fun costumes from Threads of Fright that players are wearing in-game. Telesto... Dark Vador. That's pretty good use of Kallus. Pyramid Head. I feel like I've done this before. This is a good one. And Dylan has personally assured me that they are just too scared of Meat Clown to allow Meat Clown to win. But Meat Clown clearly is the best. So go to my Twitter if you don't know what I'm talking about. all right. What's on deck for the TWAB this week? Crafting's on the mind. We have some fun news on deck for next season, and we're looking at some long-term goals that the team is planning to execute for Lightfall. We'll be discussing some important information around Stadia and cross-save, followed by Bungie Bounties and a Prime Rewards refresh. Let's get to it. Deepstone crafting. Huh. Since the addition of weekly raids and dungeons for pinnacle drops, we've seen more players engaging with a variety of raid activities in Destiny 2. While an increase in power is always exciting, or even the fabled chance that you raid Exotic, we're taking the opportunity next season to make your return trips to Beyond Light's Deepstone Crypt even more enticing. Starting next season, legendary Deepstone Crypt weapons can be crafted. Interesting. I knew they were getting refreshed perk pools, which I assume is part of this, but I didn't know they'd go like the full crafting route here. All right, each encounter has a chance to drop a deepset version of a raid weapon, and players may purchase one per week from the final chest when defeating Tanix. When Deepstone Crypt is the featured raid of the week, encounter drops are uncapped. Oh, okay, so that does stack. Well, that's good. Okay. This means you can run a full raid each encounter multiple times hunting for deepset drops. When it comes to these weapons, there is quite a bit of excitement internally as the team started freshening up the perk pools. We asked one of our resident sandbox experts, senior design lead Chris Proctor, about their approach. When updating perk pools and older weapons, our goal is to keep the most beloved combinations and drop the rest to make room for new perks. With Deepstone Crypt specifically, we looked for new perks that synergize well with the perks that originated with Deepstone Crypt. Reconstruction, Recombination, and Redirection. I.e., new perk combinations could look like Reconstruction and Focus Fury, or 4 times a Charm and Redirection. Okay, so also they said that next season Deepstone Crypt perks were coming to other weapons. We'll see if they talk about that here. We also took the opportunity to add perks to weapons that have never had them before. We've created quite a few new perks since Beyond Light shipped, and we're excited to see how players mix and match for their builds. Here's some I'm personally excited for: Heritage, Reconstruction, Focus Fury. I don't love Focus Fury. Posterity, Volt Shot, Rampage. Whoa! Okay. Volt Shot, Hand Cannon, huh? Alright, I do like that. Does Rampage work on the Volt Shot stacks? That could be fun. Trustee, Rapid Hit, Incandescent. That sounds also very dope. Nice. We took this opportunity to create a new origin trait for the weapons, Bray Inheritance. And they are not explaining what that is, but yeah, they did say that when all they said before was that they were going to refresh old perk pools and give everything an origin trait. They did not say they were going to allow crafting on all the weapons, so we are speeding ahead with crafting here. Did Proctor just say Reconstruction is going to be a crafted trait? Enhance. Owners of Beyond Light can start crafting these raid weapons starting on December 6, 2022. We'll see you in space next season, Guardians. More crafting. Lightfall crafting. With the excitement around upcoming Deep Stone crafting, we felt this would be a great opportunity to talk about some plans the team is eyeballing for the system overall. When crafting was introduced in the Witch Queen, we were very excited to see how players would engage with the feature. Having a direct path to acquiring a powerful perk or god roll can be a bit risky in a game like Destiny, but we're happy with how players are taking great advantage of what the system offers. That said, there are aspects the team is looking to address, not only to help address player feedback, but to improve crafting overall. Okay. First, let's start with some of the pain points we'd like to address. Deep set weapons are far too common, which leads to some confusion over their value and vault stress. Yeah. To a new player, it can be difficult to understand which weapons are actually craftable. Yeah, they now say, like, this weapon does not give you a pattern or something now when you get a random drop on one you cannot craft. To an experienced player, deep set weapons commonly end up in the vault simply for future currency, bringing more stress to inventory management. Correct. Where's, hang on. Here we go. Yeah, here's my deep sight collection here. Some of these I finished and I'm just saving. And then others. So I can spend some of these now because I just finished enhanced crafting the BXR. But yeah, this is like, you know, dozens of spaces in my vault taken up by that. All right, deep sight weapons must be equipped for full currency extraction, causing friction with loadouts. The goal of this was so the players would try out weapons they normally wouldn't and to make the currency feel earned. It is also somewhat of a byproduct of our original multi-currency perk system, which they have now done away with completely. While this is nice to have, we'd like for players to want to try the new weapons for other reasons, not just to earn crafting currencies. Farming an encounter like Shirochi is a very efficient method for leveling. While this can be fun for some, it is tedious and provides no useful benefits to the player or encounter. There are no methods for increasing a weapon's level outside of equipping it. Interesting. Okay, so this is... I don't know if this means they're going to nerf Shirochi or if they're going to let you increase a level without just grinding out kills. As mentioned in our Sandbox Q&A, crafted base raid weapons outclass adept raid weapons. Mm-hmm. We want to maintain the value of adept weapon reward drops from master raid content. Okay, so the answer is for all these. To address these points, the team is actively working on some changes coming with Lightfall. While these changes are being developed, tested, and finalized, we want to share our list of goals and some strategies behind them. Goal, reduce deep sight weapon hoarding. Strategy, introduce alternate ways to earn deep sight currencies. Yes, good idea. Give Ava some bounties or something. I don't know. Goal, reduce bad luck in weapon recipe unlocking. Yes, very much yes. That wasn't even mentioned here, really. But strategy, provide opportunities within the crafting system to allow users to deterministically choose what weapon to target. Yeah, so the only thing we really have right now for that is like the once a season unlock that you can get where you can start picking like one deep sight weapon to unlock a week. And this season didn't even have it until they added it later. Goal, reduce loadout stress, reduce player incentives to equip a suboptimal deep sight or crafted weapon. Goal, improve the value of weapon rewards from master raid content. Strategy, give the new Lightfall raid adept weapons access to enhanced perks. Oh, okay. This is not going to be full freeform crafting. So you can't craft them, but they will be able to have enhanced perks. I think that's all really what people were asking for. I think that's like not a terrible middle ground, at least in the interim here. Like if you can get, I don't know if it'll be like guaranteed enhanced perks on all adept weapons. That might be a little extreme, especially since you can pick between perks and stuff. But the chance for enhanced perks to drop on those naturally is actually a good idea. So. In the near term, we do want to give players a heads up. Starting in Lightfall, weapons that cannot be crafted will no longer drop at deep sight. This will help us achieve our goal of reducing deep sight weapon hoarding and alleviate some stress on your vaults. Players who currently have these weapons in their inventory should complete their deep sight objectives and extract their elements before February 28th. All right, so we have, 4 months to avoid loss of resonant elements. And you can also just shard them for 100 instead of 300. Okay, so that's all pretty good. I mean, it's not happening until Lightfall, so we might have like one more very grindy crafting season next season with season 19, but we'll see if anything maybe can change in the short term. Most of this does seem planned for Lightfall as opposed to next season, but we'll see if anything slides in there. Deep sight crafting is, deep sight crafting is whatever, but just the, I mean, it's good, but like, I'm very excited about some of these new roles. That seems very cool. Because I really do like that weapon set. Stadia is dying. No, they don't say that. But They don't have a long-term plan. We do have a short-term plan. All players who have their main characters on Stadia should set up cross-save so they don't lose access. If you don't set up cross-save by January 18th, you will lose access. So you should just set up cross-save. That is the solution. If you don't do this, you may permanently lose your character, apparently. After January 18th, players with Stadia as their active characters should not deactivate cross-save for any reason. Doing so will result in a complete loss of characters. Wow, Google really screwed everybody with that, huh? Alright, Bungie bounties. Whatever. You can read that if that concerns you. I don't think I've ever cared about Prime rewards. Workarounds for converting pages. Yeah, there's still people running into this issue. Clear your console or PC. How do you clear your console cache? I've never even heard of that. Lead a strike, obtain more spectral pages. Hopefully that's not affecting too many people anymore. But we will see. Known issues. I think they've gotten most of the major ones this season at this point. Yeah, the all pages manifested message appears. You're not losing any pages when this appears, but it's just always appearing. I have noticed that for sure. And then movie of the week. We are in like spooky mode here. Art of the week. That's good. I like that. This is good too. Titan Gundams. And no meat clown. No meat clown anywhere. Just real tragedy. All right. It's been a while since I've had the pleasure of writing one of these. It's always a thrill to dive in just a bit deeper with what's coming to Destiny and what the team is excited about. Make no mistake, these are honestly written by a good-sized group of folks here at Bungie, subject matter experts, editors, localizers, asset creators, and so many more. Sometimes may be brief, some may be massive, but each one is authored with the same amount of love. Thanks for stopping by for another blog installment. Until next time, be dreaming of a fully crafted trusty. Which DSC weapon are you most looking forward to? Holler at us in the comments. I am actually very excited about the DSC stuff. Like, I think that's a good idea, and like, obviously I think the idea is to roll that out to all raids, I think, at least all the ones that they're not gonna sunset. They've said they're not sunsetting Shadowkeep, so I would imagine that Garden may be on the list next there, and I guess Vogue could be too, so you could craft Vogue weapons. And they said pretty much all existing raids in the game are going to get reworked for pools and an Origin Trait. And since Origin Traits only started with Witch Queen, there's still at least, you know, a couple raids that they have to go back to now. I wonder if Last Wish is ever going to be cut completely. I know they're selling the, like, Forsaken pack or whatever, but it's technically not part of Shadowkeep, and that's all they said was they're not sunsetting any more expansions, so Last Wish is kind of up in the air. But I certainly would love a ton of new perks on those weapons and the ability to craft them and a cool Last Wish Origin trait. That would be very cool. I'd probably want that more than Garden, honestly. But yeah, so these changes, like the general changes to crafting, well, we don't have any details. They seem to at least recognize the problems. It's just very clear that like crafting is just such a massive part of the game now that it's like kind of overwhelming. Everything else and like the RNG loot chase like it used to be, but I don't know. I know some people prefer it, but I still can't fully get behind crafting. But as I see, we are doubling and tripling down on it kind of with each passing season and now year here. So anyway, that's all I got for now. And I will get back to writing tomorrow after my very fun hospital stay. But thank you for all everyone who wished me well for that. But yeah, I'm okay. Don't worry about it. All right, I will talk to you guys soon. Take care.